In this video, we're going to talk about power supplies with user-selectable switches. Now, power supplies with user-selectable switches means that we can actually select operation from either a 110-volt input or a 230-volt input, and this is done depending on how you're going to use the product in an AC infrastructure, or maybe you're using the product in a different country. Now, when a power supply ships out of the warehouse, it is set for 230 volts. The reason why it's set to 230 volts as a default is we don't want that power supply mistakenly being connected to a 230 volt circuit if it was set to 120. Now, what happens in these situations is that when the user gets the unit and doesn't realize this, there's a couple of things that happen. They'll plug it into 120 volts and the power supply may turn on, and it may actually produce the correct output voltage until they go load the power supply. And when they do that, the power supply voltage drops, the power supply shuts off, and immediately it looks like it is a failure. So one of the most common failures we get with a supply of this type is indeed the user forgetting to set the selectable switch to the correct voltage, and therefore it simulates a failure. So it's important that you check the data sheet and ensure that the switch is set to the right spot. All right, so some power supplies will have the user selectable switch very visible on the output of the box here, very close to the AC terminals. There are some other power supplies where it may not be so obvious, where the switch is actually on the side, and then other supplies that are much lower in power may have the switch kind of hidden in between the grid. So you may actually find it on the side, or you may have to find it on top. In any case, you could check the data sheet to ensure where the switch location is. If you're not sure, give us a call here at TRC.